And we're looking at the start list for the 250-metre flying time trial. Interesting situation to start with, though, because there are seven sprinters in the men's competition, but we will be starting with the tandem. So Cruz and Forstermann getting themselves ready for the Paralympic Games later on this year. So we're going to see how fast they can go as a tandem combination up against some of the stars of global cycling in the sprint competition. Max Levy, number one, he's the big favourite on home track, getting themselves ready for the Paralympic Games. So Robert Forstermann, the multiple world champion for the team sprint for Germany, Olympic medalist as well, and now making the transition as he gets to the twilight years of his sprinting career to help out Heike Cruz, perhaps go for a paracycling Olympic medal. Look at the powerful legs of Robert Forstermann, famous in cycling circles, perhaps even outside of the cycling circles because of the size of his thighs, short in stature, but he's almost as wide as he is high. His thighs are incredibly muscular. And we can see the speed now they're trying to do. It's 250 metres, one lap of the track. Track record for the six-day series, 12.05 from Stefan Botticher. He did that in 2018. And we'll have to wait for the official timing. 12.578. So a good time by the tandem pairing. 12.578. Just about half a second slower than the outright track record held by Stefan Botticher. But that's a very fast time for a blind and vision impaired tandem team. So the combination of former world champion Robert Forstermann with Kai Cruz looking very good heading towards the Paralympic Games later this year. And a lot of support by the crowd here in Berlin, no doubt. Now it's time for the elite men's sprint competition to really get underway, with the tandem riders having their crack at the flying lap. And Owen Mullen, number seven, the first of the sprinters to come. He's the Irish sprint champion. Won 13 national titles, sprint, Kieran, and 1,000 metre time trial. 26-year-old from Galway. We saw him race in London at the start of the six-day series. He had a nasty crash, wasn't able to finish the final night of competition. They had a big crash in the Kieran. Fully recovered since then. Another rider looking towards the Olympic Games 2020. Such a big competition, big season for so many of the riders that are focusing on the Olympic Games in Tokyo. So the sprinters normally go for 200 metre qualifying times. Here in Berlin, though, it's a full lap of the track, 250 metres. And Noah Mullen, the first of the sprinters to get underway. 250 metres to go. Just flips up outside of the red line going into the back straight. So losing a little bit of time. Almost does the same through the final bend as well. And 13.646 for Owen Mullen. Slower than we saw the tandem combination. Had a shake of the head there from Owen. He knows that's not going to be good enough. With the caliber of riders still to come, he knows that a 13.6 is not going to be getting into the final of the sprints later on this afternoon. So the number six of the seven riders. And this is an interesting one. This is Asau Elben, 18-year-old from India. And he has the privilege of being the first Indian rider to win a world championship sprint medal, a world championship cycling medal. He's only 18. But he has been a world champion in the under-19 World Championships. He won the team sprints at the World Championships last year. Second in the sprint competition, third in the Kirin. That was held in Germany, not at this track though. It was at Frankfurt. So a new generation of sprinters. And this one is coming from a place that's not well known for the caliber of international track cyclists. So leading the way for India, it's Esau Albon, a youngster from Port Blair. And from the island of Andaman in the Indian Ocean. And let's see what he can do. He knows the time to beat, 13.6 from Owen Mullen. And he looks comfortable on the bike. He's only a teenager, 18 years of age. And Albon down the back straight. He looks the part. He's hugging the bottom of the track around the final bends. And he's much quicker. 13.3, so much faster than Owen Mullen. Not as quick as the tandem team. It's still a good ride. Esau Albon, 18-year-old from India. First chance I've had to look at him on the track. And he looks comfortable. Really does look part of the track. Like Spencer. Very comfortable, very balanced. So three medals at the Under-19 World Championships last year in Frankfurt. And looks like he's going to be a star of the future. In the pink colours. Number five comes from Taiwan, 21 years of age. So another youngster. Nainasing Sai. He is capable of a very fast time. He's been riding the World Cup Series. And he sets a Taiwanese 200-meter flying record. So he raced at the World Cup in Glasgow back in November. 9.921 seconds for 200 meters. Let's see how he goes for the extra 50. One lap of the track here is 250 meters. Capable of going under 10 seconds for 200, so he is a very fast rider. Early out of the saddle though, as he comes down the back straight, trying to build up to maximum speed, and he's very high at the moment. Hugging the fence, maximum elevation as he comes to the flying lap now. 12.5, that's the fastest time, but that was from the tandem combination of Cruz and Forsterman. 13.3, that was the Indian rider's time, and it's going to be faster. So Albon was 13.3, and now Din Singh with a 13.1. So some good track sprinters coming from non-traditional countries. Taiwan certainly very important in terms of the industry of bicycle manufacturing. Almost all of the best bikes on the planet coming out of Taiwan. They haven't had too many elite cyclists though. They're trying to buck that trend, the youngster, the 21-year-old. Fastest of the individual times so far. Thomas Barbeck from the Czech Republic, 32-year-old. He won the sprint competition in Bremen last week. He's very experienced, been around for a long time. Second at the World Championships in the Kilo, the 1 kilometre time trial back in 2017. He's also the bronze medalist that year in the Kirin. He's been the European Kirin champion in 2016. So a couple of years on, let's see if Thomas Barbeck still has the speed, the kind of speed that took him to World Championship medals. Trying to get the crowd up and about. He wants the support, extra motivation. I think the crowd are just waiting for the German riders still to come, including Max Levy. Coming around to get the bell now, Thomas Barbeck, the Czech Republic. certainly capable of getting the fastest time of the individual riders. A little bit messy though as he goes down around the final bend. And quicker again, so 12.9. Still not as fast as the tandem combination, but the fastest of the individuals. 12.9 for Thomas Barbeck. Fastest of the sprinters at the Brayman 6 day last week. Let's see what he can do here though in Berlin. Still a big favourite still to come. Anton Huhr, then Max Dornbach and Max Levy. Berliner, the last rider to come. So Forstemann still leads the way, but that is the tandem combination. Barbeck, the fastest of the individuals with a 12.9, the first of the individuals to go under 13 seconds for a lap. So Anton Hune, youngster from Cottbus, only 19, so another star of the future. Cottbus, one of the major cities just to the south of Berlin. The Leipzig, Cottbus and Berlin, very famous for cycling cities. A lot of history, great cyclists that have come out of Cottbus. And this 19-year-old, Anton Hune, could be the next of them. Under 23 European 1,000-metre time trial champion. That was last year. So over four laps of the track, he's incredibly fast. Let's see what Anton can do for one fast lap of the track. Two riders still to come after this one. So the final three riders are all Germans. And Anton Hune from 19-year-old from Cottbus. Will it be the fastest time? Oh, just outside, so 13.0, second fastest of the individual sprinters, third overall time. So the under 23 European kilometre time trial champion with the second best of the individual sprint times. Still Kai Kruse and Robert Forstemann lead the way with a 12.5, and then it's a big gap, isn't it, back to Barbeck and Huhne. Rider number two, an ultimate rider to come now. This is Max Dornbach, 24-year-old, and he'll have the German support. He's the national sprint champion. He's won that the last two seasons. He's also the kilometre time trial champion. So he's good on the longer distances over four laps of the track. Pure sprint speed has been good as well, winning the national title the last two seasons. And he's a former under 19 or a junior world champion in the kilometre time trial. So German Max Dornbach, we'd expect a fast time from him. He is the penultimate rider. Dornbach comes around, you'll hear the sound of the bell. He'll be looking to rock the velodrome here in Berlin. The crowd will be behind him. One of the German favourites, the 24-year-old. He's got a couple of years of experience now, but still fairly young in terms of outright age. And Max Dornbach fighting the final bends. Ooh, just under 13 seconds. Third fastest time. Second fastest of the individual sprinters. I was expecting a tad more from Max. Maybe holding back a little bit. It's a big week of competition for the sprinters. So Dornbach. Third fastest outright time, but importantly, the second fastest of the individual sprinters. So Forstemann and Kruse, That was more of an exhibition time trial for them. They don't go into the rest of the competition, of course, being in a tandem. The crowd will certainly be excited now. The Berliner, Maximilian Levy, 32-year-old, multiple world champion, team sprint and Kirin specialist. Very handy when it comes to the individual sprint as well. Four times a world champion. Focus on the Tokyo Olympic Games yet again. Key rider in Germany's team sprint. But for now, maximum speed is what it's all about. Here in Berlin, he'll have plenty of support. On his home track, he is the favourite, seeded number one. He set a six-day series flying 200-metre time trial record in London at the start of the series. So let's see what he can do with the extra 50 metres. 250 metres, one lap of the track here. Max Levy down the back straight, winding up to maximum speed. Iron Max underway now, one lap of the track. Can he beat the time of the tandem of 12.5? He doesn't have to. He just has to beat the best of the individual riders. And he almost did beat the tandem, 12.584. It's the fastest of the individual sprinters. So he will go into the sprint final later on tonight. As expected, the favourite on paper and the favourite in reality, Max Levy, the 32-year-old Berliner. Not quite quick enough to beat his former teammate in Robert Forsterman and Kai Kruse on the tandem, but he's the fastest of the individual sprinters. So maximum points for Max Levy in the overall sprint competition, and that'll qualify him into the sprint final. So we can have a look at the results, confirmation of them. Kruse and Forsterman on the tandem with a 12.5. Then we can see that Max Levy down there in eighth place, but you can see the time, 12.5, is the fastest of the individual sprinters ahead of Thomas Barbeck. So those two will go into the sprint final. It'll be Dornbach versus Anton Hoene. So it will be Max Levy up against Thomas Barbeck in the sprint final. Dornbach versus Hoene racing for third and fourth. And then it'll be very interesting to see Alban and Sai, two youngsters of sprinting, racing each other as well. So it'll be a three-up sprint for the final. Alan Mullen will be in the mix as well.